nice and tight. Gotta screw this. Oh! Mr. C, WunderSTEM Hotline, how may I help you? Yep. Oh, that's a great question. Yep. I know the perfect person. Absolutely. We'll get it posted online and you can check it all out afterwards. All right, thanks. Bye. That was Carrie, and she was wondering, where do firefighters get the tools that they use in the field and during rescue situations? Well, I know the perfect person. His name is Scott Cornell. He's a mechanical engineer, and he happens to be my brother. That's right. He is a STEM fanatic, and he makes the most amazing tools. Let's go check it out.
My name is Scott Cornell, and I'm the Director of Engineering here at Genesis Rescue. So I went to college at Wright State University and got my Bachelor's of Science in Mechanical Engineering. And I've had a lot of different jobs, from co-ops working with lasers to designing racks for the chrome plating industry, all the way to now working with extrication tools, designing, manufacturing, and assembling them and helping with that whole process here at Genesis Rescue. So in the field of engineering, you're solving problems. And with problems comes failure, and with failure come more problems that you need to solve. So problems is our currency in engineering. We are constantly fixing problems and solving people's problems. So having those problems occur in a controlled environment is great, because then you can pinpoint those, you can fix them, you can make them better. But also in the real field of the fireman out at a rescue scene, those problems will occur too, and we need to think of all those scenarios the fireman's gonna go through or the rescue personnel is gonna go through when they're utilizing our tool, and we need to combat that with engineering. We need to figure out those problems before they happen, while they happen, and just constantly get better at what we do. I think the coolest part of the job is when you draw something from your mind, put it into the computer system, and then you create the physical. So like it was a dream of yours in your brain, and then you get to hold it. That is such a rewarding thing in the engineering field, is just coming up with that solution either on your own or with a team of people, and then getting to see other people out in the field using it and how it's solving their problems and making their lives easier. That is a very powerful thing from my perspective. We start in the computer usually designing the components, and with that we use SolidWorks. It's a 3D modeling software. It's a CAD package. And with that we'll design the components, we'll program them for the CNC machines, and then you go from a digital to a real life physical part. With that you have to communicate to the manufacturing department tolerances. So how precise does that part need to be? You know, what are the critical dimensions? What dimensions do you have to measure to make sure this part meets the specifications? And communicate that to the manufacturing shop. So I design it in a 3D world, but I have to move that into a physical space. And the way we do that is by making drawings and prints, by pre-programming the CNC machines with a CAM software, and that gives the code that then goes to the machine. So this is an example of one of our prints, and it starts in a raw stock form like this. So this is aluminum. So we start off at like 2.75 inches, and then the final product is 2.69 inches. So we remove material from the outer diameter, and it goes through its first process, turns into this, and then it goes through its second process, and this is its final form. You'll notice it's red. That's because it has an anodized coating to give it that red look. So this actually plugs into a tube, and it's for stabilization, and the shape is just to give it that grip. It's very sharp, so it'll press into something and hold and not move around. So this will be the final product. So some of the cool machinery and test fixturing that I get to use verifies that these machines are outputting what they should be. This is extremely important because, again, when you get out in the field, and you're about to cut someone out of a car to save their life, it needs to work every time, and it needs to be able to be strong enough to cut through that door or strong enough to spread open that door. So what we're doing here is we're making sure before it leaves our facility, it's gonna operate exactly as expected for that fireman. All right, so this is our tool line of Genesis. We could have the cutter right here, we have the ram, we have the spreader, and we have the combi tool. So as the names kind of imply, the cutter cuts, the ram pushes in a linear fashion, the spreader spreads, and the combi tool is actually a combination of the spreader and the cutter in one. And this is where we test out the tools, some of the newer tools we have, and we also have people come in and do training here at our location in Kettering, Ohio.
Wait, so I'm gonna get to cut something?
You are gonna get to cut something today, my friend. Let's check out the cutters and the spreaders and the rams. All right, Mr. C, power that tool on by hitting the red action button. And then you're gonna lift it up. So you wanna cradle it. Yep, just like that. And then slide it right into here.
From the side?
Just from the front. It's gonna naturally walk in one direction. You'll feel it. So you'll feel it grip and just, yep, let it walk with you. Now hold on. You notice it's gonna walk you that way, right?
Yeah,
so cool. Where do you not wanna be?
I don't wanna be here because...
All right, let's move you to the other side. So go ahead, come on around.
Oh, that's cool.
Yep, and just go ahead. And then go ahead and complete that cut. You're just gonna hold it full force and you're gonna feel it pop once it goes. Just keep holding it. There it is.
Oh, that was awesome.
Now go ahead and open it up.
So I open up, should I hold underneath?
You can hold underneath so it doesn't fall. Yep, and go ahead and reverse it.
That thing is super powerful. It's amazing, this beast of a monster. I mean, you could just lift it up, no problem. And what's amazing is just this one trigger button cuts this B-frame, right?
B-post.
Right apart. Oh, that's awesome.
Our tools are used in the rescue industry. The rescue industry, you don't get a second chance to do it again. You're out there at an emergency and you get one shot at it. And it is a very high precision tool that we produce that has to be right every time. So my background helps define what the tool needs to be, from the test procedures we do on it to the high precision of manufacturing that we use when creating it. So there's a lot of knowledge that I've learned in schooling and just along the way in my career path that lets me leverage that knowledge into making a better tool, because it has to be right every time. So this is a tool insert. So this is actually what does the machining on the lathe, and we just want to make sure there's no breaks. Kind of here's an example of a broken one, and this allows us to see it a little closer and see the detail of our tool wear as we're machining the parts. So what we do here, and what I specifically do as an engineer here, is very important, because there's a firefighter out there using the tool that left this facility. And it could be a year from now, it could be a week from now. But to me, that's a little scary, because we know we have to get it right, but that responsibility is exciting, and you know you're helping someone out there. So when that product leaves here, I know it's gonna go in the hands of the right person and they'll do good things with it. That's very rewarding for me. And I love to think about that, even though it's a little scary in the scenarios they're using them. It's exciting to me to know that we can produce something that can be of such importance out there for the rescue industry. My favorite thing to do at work is connecting and understanding the different way all the small cells of manufacturing operate together. So you have design, you have manufacturing, you have assembly, and then you have shipping and distribution. So our tools then leave this facility and get distributed out by our dealers and our distributors. So for me, it's just understanding and working within all four of those little cells as the tool travels through and making sure that the tool gets all the checks and makes sure it operates as it should in every one of those cells. These are where the raw materials come in and they get staged, so you can see the different variations of components that we'll be making out of these raw stock pieces of aluminum, steel. So this is the staging area as we collect components that are going to go into the final assembly that have been manufactured. Depending on what tool is going to be made, the different kits are sitting on these shelves. So if I had an opportunity to go back in time and talk to myself, I think I would say failure's okay. You know, we get hung up so often on failing and making mistakes and we really beat ourselves up about it. But in honesty, the failures that we have make us stronger and better. And I look back at all the failures in my life and I think those are really what made me who I am today. The successes are easy, but the failures are the challenges that make us overcome the things that we have problems with, and they make us better. So that's one thing I would say to them. And then also in school, you know, just if things are challenging in the beginning, just keep at them. They get easier. Nobody's an expert from the start, unless you just happen to be, you know, gifted in that area, but you can work at things and really get to where you want to be if that's the goal you have.
What an amazing career. Scott uses STEM in every part of his job, whether he's designing, manufacturing, or deploying the tool and testing it in the real world to ensure that it's working properly. Scott uses STEM to make sure that firefighters have a dependable tool that they can use each and every day to save lives. The ram pushes things apart. The spreader can spread and lift. The cutter literally snipped the car into two parts when I got to use it. It was so awesome. I wonder. What would you build if you were a mechanical engineer? Do you have some amazing ideas? Oh, I'm also wondering, will you join us for another episode of WunderSTEM as we explore these amazing careers? I sure hope so. Until then, let's see if I can get this thing to work. See ya.